This NASA prototype robot isn't exploring a remote planet, but the frozen tundra of Greenland. Researchers hope that Grover, or Goddard remotely operated vehicle for exploration and research, can teach them how to prepare robots for harsh conditions.
Our main concern and main motivation to come over here was to be able to test it in the extreme environment, and temperature is definitely one of the most difficult issues to deal with, because electronics and batteries and pretty much all the components of the robot behave differently at these cold temperatures. And so we tested all the different systems in the cold. We let the robot outside for many days at a time, trying to see if that would affect it. And from what we can tell, we have very good performance in the cold.
In addition to cold weather testing, Grover helped analyze snow accumulation on Greenland between May and June of this year. Two students from Boise State University joined a NASA glaciologist to help study the area using the robot's built-in radar.
This bright white line here is the 2012 melt layer.
We're measuring several different things about the snowpack with the radar. The big one that we're interested in right now is the melt that happened in July of last year, July of 2012, was a fairly unique event. And so there was some ice that covered most of Greenland's surface. And it has snowed since, so there's about 60 centimeters of snow on top of that.
The radars on Grover will not only be able to look at accumulation, but will also be able to resolve how large that melt layer is and start to look at the quantity of water that melted and then percolated down and refroze.
Studying snowmelt on Greenland is important. Because of snow and ice's reflective properties, it helps keep the planet cool. As snow and ice melt, the Earth absorbs more of the sun's energy and starts to warm up, according to researchers. Grover's wide treads allow it to gain traction in snowy and icy conditions. Some of its instruments and batteries are powered by two slanted solar panels on the robot's sides. Before sending Grover to the icy environment of Greenland, the team tested it on a beach in Maryland. When on Greenland, the robot was remotely controlled, which is also one of the tasks the team is trying to perfect. By perfecting the remote control of a robot that may be a few meters or kilometers away, it paves the way for better control of robots that are tens or hundreds of thousands of kilometers away on remote planets. Nick Barber, IDG News Service.